गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास 9। टुडे विल स्टार्ट विद आवर फर्स्ट टॉपिक दैट इज़ कम्युनिकेशन स्किल्स। सो बिफोर वी स्टार्ट विद कम्युनिकेशन स्किल कंटेंट, आई जस्ट वॉन्ट यू पीपल टू नो वॉट इज़ कम्युनिकेशन। कैन एनी वन ऑफ यू जस्ट रिकॉल वॉट इज़ कम्युनिकेशन? राइट नाउ वॉट वी आर हैविंग इन बिटवीन अस इज़ अ कम्युनिकेशन। सो वॉट इज़ कम्युनिकेशन? Communication is a two-way process where you exchange, you share your ideas. So this communication skill plays very, very vital role in exchange of information. The process of passing any information from one person to other person with the aid of some medium is termed as communication. So there's a sender, there's a receiver, and there's a medium through which you communicate with your receiver. So the medium can be anything. Can any one of you just remember which all mediums are being used for communication? Right now, which medium I'm using to communicate with you? Yes, I'm using social networking site, that is YouTube, to get connected with you. So the medium which I'm using is internet. I'm using my mobile, I'm using my computer for recording, for typing. You people are using your headphones. So these all are the equipments or gadgets which are used as in a medium for communication. If in a class I'm teaching you, then we are having direct face-to-face communication. If I'm sending a text message to you, so at that time I'm using social media as a communication. Okay, so the medium can be anything. Now we will see different types of communication. See, this communication is broadly categorized into three: verbal, non-verbal, and visual. So what is verbal communication? Verbal means oral or a spoken communication. Right now we are having which sort of communication? We are having verbal communication. Okay, so in verbal communication, I am writing the notes on PowerPoint. You people are reading the notes. So there's a written as well as there is oral communication. Then the second type of communication is non-verbal communication. So what is non-verbal communication? See, your body posture, your gesture, your eye contact, your body movements, your paralanguage, facial expressions, the way you give the space, the touch, the feel, this all comes under non-verbal communication. So the way you stand, the way you wear, the way you dress up, this all speaks your language. Okay, the way you express, suppose you make your eyes little bigger, that means you're getting angry. So a smile on your face indicates that there's a positivity. The anger on your face indicates that there's a negativity, there's an anger. So this non-verbal communication is also very, very important type of communication. Next is visual communication. What is visual communication? Can anyone of you know? See, visual communication is nothing but graph, maps, drawing diagrams, your parking signs, boardings, hoardings, okay, objects. This speaks a lot. So a picture speaks a lot. So suppose there's a picture saying that there's a rambler. A picture says this path is used only for walking. It is not used for vehicle. A red signal on a road indicates it is a car or a vehicles are supposed to stop. That means red says stop, green says go. So this all parking signs, graph, this speaks a lot. So this is visual type of communication. Now what we will do is we will individually emphasize on each sort of communication. Okay, before we do that, we will all see what is importance of communication. See, why the communication plays a vital role in our life. What is the reason for communication? This communication is used for sharing knowledge, strengthening your relationship, act as a base of coordination, increasing confidence, relieving stress, happiness, managing, leadership, helps in socializing, controlling, process. So see, without communication, there's no life. Unless and until you speak out, you express yourself, people may not understand what you are trying to say. So if you want to speak out, you need to communicate. It can be either a verbal, it can be non-verbal or visual. Okay. So which all are the characteristics of communication? It involves at least two persons in a communication, minimum two persons. There's exchange of ideas. It is two-way process. It requires a medium. It is continuous process. Communication is systematic and it is having cultural circumstances. Okay. Now, in written communication, you use a medium with a written document. So which all are advantages of written communication? See, suppose there's a newspaper. So what this newspaper is having? This newspaper is having news about politics. It is having news about advertisement. So by sitting at home, by sitting in a corner of a world, you all come to know what all is going on around you. So this written communication is very, very important. If you get a pamphlet, so in a pamphlet there is a advertisement. So you come to know that in this so-so location, you are supposed to go and visit over there to see what all has been happening over there. So what all are the advantages of written communication? Data gets saved for future reference. You do not need immediate feedback. Easily understood. Duplication is easy. Easy for legal tenders. No misinterpretations. What all are the disadvantages of this written communication? There's wastage of time and cost. Storage is expensive. Lack of secrecy. Lack of flexibility. Understanding problem. Okay, this all are minor drawbacks of written communication. Okay, now we will turn towards verbal communication. Which all are the advantages of this verbal or spoken communication? You save time and cost. There's a quick feedback. Immediately the moment I teach in a class, you all are sitting in front of me. I can read your faces. I can read the expressions. Whether you are physically, mentally present in class or you are mentally absent in class. So it becomes very easy as you get quick feedback. It is more convenient. Ease of preparation. It is flexible and effective. Better understanding. More reliable. Which all can be the disadvantages of your verbal communication? Difficult with lengthy messages. See, if it is a lengthy message, if I want to express, I want to complete one whole textbook, then I cannot stand in front of you for a whole day and continuously speak out. So at that time, for lengthy communication, it is not possible. Language issues may occur. Right now, we are using a language as English. But suppose if I'm having an accent of some other language and if you're unable to understand, then there can be a problem. There's no secrecy and which may create misinterpretations. Okay, so this is written communication and non-verbal communication. Okay, now in non-verbal communication, as we have understood, that sharing of information message is done without using spoken or written words. Okay, so which language is used over here? The language of postures, your eyes, your facial expressions, your body movements, okay, your gestures, so your paralanguage, this all have been used in non-verbal communication. Okay. Which all are the advantages of this non-verbal communication? Can anyone of you just think of it? Which all can be advantages of this? Easy to understand. Easy presentation. Attract audiences. Saves time. Helps illiterate people. Quick expression. See, if it is written and if a person or receiver is illiterate, he may not read. if I'm speaking in English and the receiver is not knowing English, still he may not gain. But the moment I just make my hand movements indicating that you have to get out or you have to get in, or if I do namaste, the person in front of me, irrespective of whether he's literate or illiterate, he'll easily understand. So there's a quick expression. Which all are the disadvantages? Long conversation is not possible, difficult to understand, and it is costly. Okay. Types of visual communication. In visual communication, a picture express the words. Okay, so here there's a picture showing that three ladies are trying to fill their containers with water. They all are having conversation with them. They all look as in village ladies filling water and discussing their issues. Okay, the sign words, which also speaks a lot. So this all comes under visual communication. Okay, now kids, what we are going to do is we are going to start with the cycle of communication. See, communication is not one way. It includes at least two people in a communication. So it is a process. This process is a nothing but a communication cycle, which includes sender, which includes a medium, which includes the receiver, and also noise over there. So there's an idea been generated in the sender's brain, then it gets encoded into a form of words, sentences. So suppose I want to speak with you, first there should be a rough idea in my mindset that what I have to talk with you all. Then I will convert it in a form of sentences, in a form of communication. Then I will choose a medium or channel through which I will reach to you. At your end, again you will decode it. You will try to understand it at your own level. Okay. So, while doing this whole process, there may be a noise. So, what is noise? Noise is unwanted sound, which creates disturbance in the communication. So this noise is also a part of communication channel. So here comes the whole process of communication. Again, after receiving the information, the receiver needs to give back the feedback to the sender that whether he has received, whether it is positive or negative. So it is essential to give back the feedback. Okay. Now, which all are the factors affecting the communication? See, there might be a conceptual clarity, language, your visual perceptions, moods, feeling, interest. See, it depends. The content is same, but the person delivering to you is different. Some of may get directly connected to you. You may find that this teacher is having proper communication. The other teacher is not having proper communication. So it depends on the conceptual clarity, the language they use for expressing, the visual perceptions, the mood and the feelings, which includes the interest of the teacher, your prejudice, then your timeliness, whether you're completing the lecture in given time slots, environment, channel, and your past experience. These all are the factors which affects your communication. Okay. Now, written skill. What is written skill? It comes under verbal communication. It is the ability to write sentence, paragraph correctly with proper grammar. Okay. See, this is totally a different unit which we are going to see now. So, this written skill includes grammatical base. This grammatical base is having nouns, pronouns, words, adverbs, infinitives, appositives, participle, preposition, absolute. So this all have been included in this written skills. So what is word? A word is nothing but a smallest meaningful unit. What is clause? A single unit which contains subject and verb. Okay, this written skill includes sentences. Sentences can be declarative, imperative, interrogative, exclamatory, complete, complex, okay, complex compound, and only compound sentences. Which all parts of speech you must have learned? Now you all must have getting confused that This all has been there in English, and why do we have to learn in computers? See, in computer, we are just going to have a quick review on this. This all is included over here because before you understand computer language, technical language, you need to know what language is all about. Okay, so we'll just have a quick review on it. What is parts of speech? It includes noun, a name of a person, place, thing or idea. Pronoun, it is replacement of noun. So if I say, hey, you come here. So hey, you in the sense I'm calling someone. So that is a pronoun. A verb, it is nothing but an action. Adverb, which describes about a verb. Adjective, it is used to describe a noun or pronoun. Conjunction, it is used to join the words and, or, but, between. Preposition, it shows relationship of a noun to another word. Interjection, expressive words. Articles, the, a, an. Okay. Now, we will see types of paragraphs. Descriptive paragraph, narrative paragraph, expository paragraph, persuasive paragraph. It tries to get the reader to accept particular point of view or understand the writer's position. This type of paragraph will help you to understand how to write a paragraph. Okay. So, students, you are now supposed to go through your first lesson, read the lesson properly, revise it, try to solve the exercise. If you have any doubt, you have to put your doubt on WhatsApp group. Okay, all the best. Thank you. Have a good day.